Hi, I'm Dr. Leanne Kessler, a fusion consultant specializing in science communication. It's Friday, November 26th, and it's time for your fusion news update. But first, I want to wish a happy Thanksgiving and a happy American Indian Heritage Month to all of the US viewers and listeners. There's a lot of fusion in the press lately, particularly in feature articles. Stories today include 1. Congressional hearing on fusion energy research and technology development. 2. Chinese scientists say they've discovered cheap new way to do nuclear fusion. 3. The chase for fusion energy. 4. It is time to bet big on fusion energy. 5. Fusion's role in fighting climate change. 6. Nuclear fusion attracts startups and skeptics. 7. Unveiling the steady progress toward fusion energy gain. I also have a couple of bonuses for you at the end, so stick around. 1. Congressional hearing on fusion energy research and technology development. Last Wednesday, November 17th, the Energy Subcommittee of the U.S. House Committee on Science, Space, and Technology held the first congressional hearing to focus on fusion energy since 2018. At the hearing, representatives heard from leaders in fusion research from across the country, including Dr. Bob Mumgarde, CEO of Commonwealth Fusion Systems, or CFS. Hearings like this help inform both Congress and the public about the importance of private and public investment in fusion research. The timing is particularly important as the Senate is considering the infrastructure bill recently passed by the House, which contains provisions for public-private partnerships in the fusion power industry. I recommend checking out the links in the description or the Fusion Industry Association webpage, as the write-ups there include links to transcripts, summaries, and a video of the hearing, along with information about the inclusion of fusion in the Build Back Better infrastructure package. 2. Chinese scientists say they've discovered cheap new way to do nuclear fusion. Scientists at the Chinese Academy of Sciences Institute of Physics have reported initial positive results on their interesting inertial confinement fusion scheme. Their double cone ignition scheme, first proposed in 1997 by Dr. Zhang Ji, before adequate laser technology existed to test the idea, uses lasers to crush two gold cones that contain fusion fuel, creating two streams of plasma that collide and ideally create fusion. The team, led by Dr. Zhang Ji, is attempting to create a cheaper, simpler path to inertial confinement fusion than the larger, more powerful experiments like the National Ignition Facility, or NIF, in the US do. While their initial results focus mostly on overcoming experimental difficulties, it will be exciting to see where these experiments lead in the future. 3. The chase for fusion energy. Philip Ball wrote this piece for Nature, which takes a look at both the funding and the scientific approaches of various fusion devices and companies, including TAE Technologies, Helion Energy, CFS, General Fusion, First Light Fusion, and Tokamak Energy. Ball describes tokamak, stellarator, magnetized target, inertial confinement, and field reverse configuration design schemes with illustrations and videos based on existing or proposed devices. He also includes a discussion of the fuel options for fusion and a timeline showing the predicted path forward for different private and public fusion ventures. Speaking of the challenges posed by fusion, Chris Kelzal, CEO of Tokamak Energy, said, "Sooner or later, this will be cracked, and it will be transformative." I particularly enjoyed the graphics for this article. The illustrations and photographs really give a great overview of the differences in design and scale for some of the many devices being proposed around the world. 4. It is time to bet big on fusion energy. In this Financial Times opinion piece, John Thornhill makes the case it is time to invest in fusion energy in a big way. He argues that given the progress at ITER, the heavy investment in private fusion companies, and the proven results at companies like CFS, it is realistic to expect fusion to be putting electricity on the grid in the near future. He also points to the support of Breakthrough Energy Ventures, the energy fund founded by Bill Gates, which believes that fusion is no longer a theoretical scientific concept. In response to the argument that money should be spent on extant technologies, like wind and solar, Thornhill quotes John Doerr, the chair of the venture capital firm Kleiner Perkins. "We need the now and we need the new. We have to execute at scale and speed." In addition to this article, Mr. Thornhill spoke with Dr. Bob Mungard, CEO of CFS, at the Tough Tech Summit, and that video is linked in the description. 5. Fusion's role in fighting climate change. Two Princeton scientists, Dr. Robert Goldston and Dr. Jacob Schwartz, penned this piece on fusion and climate change for the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists. While optimistic about the role fusion will play in the energy future, they are doubtful that fusion will take a substantial role in the Biden administration's goal to decarbonize U.S. electrical production by 2035. However, given the world's growing energy needs, they predict fusion will be an important part of a diverse, low-carbon energy landscape in the latter half of this century. This article is a very informative read, covering a lot of background on fusion energy, including references. It also covers a variety of fusion concepts, including ITER, the NIF, General Fusion, CFS, Tokamak Energy, Renaissance Fusion, and Type 1 Energy. 6. Nuclear fusion attracts startups and skeptics. This article in the Wall Street Journal covers a few recent developments in fusion energy. Reporter Julia Petroni presents the recent report on fusion companies from the Fusion Industry Association and the UK Atomic Energy Authority, and progress at ITER, CFS, General Fusion, and Zap Energy, alongside concerns from other experts. While companies like CFS and General Fusion hope to put electricity on the grid by the 2030s as an important part of the fight against climate change, skeptics believe this timeline is not just unrealistic, but distracting from existing technology that could help combat climate change right now. Despite this, large investments and the growing private fusion sector point to a willingness to invest in the future of fusion. Tim Luce, the head of science and operation at ITER, said, "If we hope to survive as a civilization for more than 100 years, it would be extremely short-sighted to only invest as a planet in things that could pay off in 20 years. 7. Unveiling the steady progress toward fusion energy gain. Phys.org reported on an invited talk on the progress of fusion energy given by Sam Wurzel, a technology to market advisor for the U.S. Department of Energy. This talk was given at the American Physical Society Division of Plasma Physics annual conference in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 2 weeks ago. In it, Wurzel presents on the progress fusion has made over the past 60 years by using the fusion triple product, or the product of density, temperature, and confinement time. This figure of merit allows a comparison of the progress of different approaches to fusion confinement, and Wurzel used this comparison to see how older technologies, such as tokamaks, are progressing, as well as comparing the performance of novel technology to the more established methods. Finally, let's check out the bonus fusion news this week. First, more fusion YouTube videos. Check out these videos from General Fusion and Undecided with Matt Farrell. General Fusion discusses the recent UN climate change conference, while Matt Farrell interviews Dr. Martin Greenwald about CFS's recent magnet achievement. Next, nuclear fusion is close enough to start dreaming. This opinion column by Tyler Cohen, published in Bloomberg and reprinted in several other publications, ponders the consequences of living in a world with cheap, clean electricity from fusion. Inspired by the recent funding of Helion's pulsed fusion design, along with other fusion breakthroughs, this piece focuses less on fusion technology and more on the theoretical idea of free or cheap energy, including flying on hydrogen-fueled planes and buying with environmentally friendly cryptocurrency. Also, physicists want to create energy like stars do. These two ways are their best shot. This article in Popular Science compares the magnetic and inertial confinement regimes of ITER and the NIF. It also discusses the potential of other facilities, such as Laser Megajoule in France and Shenguang 4 in China, to substantially contribute to the laser-based fusion research. Finally, why Elon Musk should build a nuclear fusion reactor in Texas. This tongue-in-cheek article by Tristan Green on the Next Web calls on Elon Musk, the CEO of Tesla and SpaceX, and the richest man in the world, to build a fusion reactor in Texas to help fight climate change. While there isn't any new information on fusion in this piece, it could be entertaining. That's all for fusion news this week. Have a great holiday weekend if you're here in the US, and stay tuned for our next update. Please like and subscribe for more fusion news, and check out the links in the description if you want more information.